Hi, I'm Dr.Leela Mohan. I practice at Manipal, Columbia Asia, Padithem Healthcare, located in HSR, Bangalore. So Hepatitis B is a viral infection. There are a lot more viral infections. Along with that, Hepatitis B, Hepatitis C, Hepatitis A. So what is this Hepatitis B and why we should be worried? Hepatitis B mainly spreads through blood, semen, and the oral fluids. If a non-infected person gets contact with an infected person, then easily the disease can be transmitted. The early signs of Hepatitis B are easy fatigability, headache, mild fever, yellowish discoloration of the skin or the sclera, that is your eyeballs will be turned into yellow color, which is the early sign, and dark colored urine, or we can color it as, or we can say it as like a tea colored urine, and extreme tiredness, that is nothing but easy fatigability, sometimes bradycardia and tachycardia, and little chills associated with mild fever, loss of appetite, nausea and vomiting, and mild abdomen discomfort. As I already said, dark colored urine, muscle cramps, and pale or dark colored stools sometimes. Hepatitis B mainly spreads through unprotected sex. So what is this unprotected sex? And if the same unprotected sex, if you would have been done with multiple sexual partners, so the risk of the Hepatitis B getting is very common. And the other thing is, like when we go to the salon shops or barber shops, when they use the razors, all those things, there are certain things which can cause the transmission of the Hepatitis B. When the barbershop people are not using the razors properly, if they're not sanitizing, if they're not sterilizing it, if they're not using the new blades, this all can happen. And then one more thing is, there are certain things called as like IV drug usage. IV drug usage is nothing but our youth is getting, spoiled by consuming the drugs. And when they administer the drugs, the same syringe will be used by the other person. This is how the Hepatitis B spreads very easily. The healthcare professionals like doctors and nurses and compounders who is working in hospitals, they are easily prone to get the Hepatitis B because they regularly come in contact with the blood. So we don't know, and that is why we have to be very careful. And there is another entity that is called as mother to child transmission, that will be very easily it will occur through Hepatitis B. And then when we use certain items like toothbrush or blades or razors or small needles, also causes the transmission of the Hepatitis B. And there are certain things called as like tattooing and the acupuncture. And there are certain other modern things which will be followed by the youth. Is very risky, and we should be very careful when we are getting done such things. So what is the major difference between this Hepatitis C and Hepatitis B? Hepatitis B mainly spreads through the blood and other body fluid, whereas the Hepatitis C only spreads through blood. So the Hepatitis C early signs are mainly easy fatigability, headaches, fever, chills, and easy bruising, bleeding, ascites, and jaundice. That is, jaundice is nothing but the yellowish discoloration of the eye, and there are certain times the yellowish discoloration of the palate also occurs in the mouth, which we can see the palate, the upper part of the mouth, when we see with the torch or something, we can easily come to know that there is an yellowish discoloration. So these are the early signs of Hepatitis C. And then when we take the early signs of Hepatitis B, there are certain signs which will be common for both Hepatitis C and Hepatitis B. So how we can cure this Hepatitis C? So the Hepatitis C can easily be cured with the medications and completely eradicated. And the Hepatitis B, always we have to give the antiviral drugs, and we have to suppress the Hepatitis B, and then we have to literally throw out the virus from our body. On this World Hepatitis Day, let us eradicate and eliminate the hepatitis. Come, join together the hands with all of us, with all healthcare practitioners and your neighbors and your colleagues. Join all your hands and educate the people and follow the safe sexual practices, the protected sex, and educate the people, educate the students. And then let us join our hands once again to eradicate the hepatitis. On this day, 28th, we will celebrate World Hepatitis Day. So we will try to prevent the risk of transmission. And one more very important thing with the Hepatitis B is nothing but vaccinate yourself. So this will be my message on this World Hepatitis Day for you all.